Oh, yes, and we got him.
Oh, I've got one. I'm in. Hey, that's really excellent. Oh, he's a big one. Fantastic fish. Absolutely beautiful. We must put her back.
Wonderful new dimension to fly fishing. We're fishing a very kind of fish, but some of the really gives you a battle on this tackle. That's what I love.
And off he goes.
The Iron Melvin Enhancement Company was formed about 10 years ago, and basically it was the local anglers got together because there was a perceived decline in the fish stocks of the Iron system. This year alone we're hoping to stock in a region of about 1.3 million fry brown trout into the feeder streams. There's the coarse angle side of it as well, where we have a state-of-the-art coarse fish hatchery. We breed tench, we breed bream, and we breed rudd. Over the past few hundred years, tench have been stocked into various ponds throughout Ireland. And in relation to the Iron system, I think they were stocked into some ponds in around Cavan, maybe 50, 60 years ago. The hatchery, it's unique for Northern Ireland. It's the only hatchery of its kind. It's a fully recirculating system, and we have full control over water temperature and light regime, so we can manipulate spawning times and growth rates, and we can produce fish maybe over two cycles in a 12-month period. The only other place would have a system like it would be Ross Craig down in the Republic, and there's nowhere else in the country. In terms of for restocking of angling waters, you have a major industry in England, in the south of England, but the fish wouldn't be produced on an intensive scale like what we have. They would be done in pond culture out in the open because they have the climate to do that. France, Germany, and over into Eastern Europe, it's a massive industry. Most of the fish that they produce out there are the coarse fish rather than the salmonids, because the environment, the climate is more suitable to that. Also, a lot of them countries would eat coarse fish in around Christmas time, would be historically the time that they would eat, whereas over here that we wouldn't consider eating coarse fish. They'd just be released back once they've been caught. Everything that we produce is for restocking out into the lakes and the rivers of the county, purely from an angling point of view. The tench would be regarded as a prize sporting fish for the coarse angler. Good, strong, fighting fish, and if you hit them in good numbers, you can bag up with good weights. There's opportunities in the county from an angling point of view, tourism development. So it's the natural idea would be that some of the stillwater lakes in the county, stocks can be enhanced with other species of fish, namely tench, so that it adds as an attraction to the county for the visiting anglers. The broodstock we get are brought in from the Iron system. We have some of the commercial netsmen who are fishing the Iron get the tench as a bycatch, and normally they just return them back to the lake, but they give me a ring whenever the fish are mature, and I come and collect maybe 20 or 30 tench each year and bring them up to the hatchery and spawn them in around June time. The limiting factor in getting them spread through the Iron would probably be water temperature. The upper Iron would be significantly more warmer. In summer, could be up to 6-7 degrees warmer, and it's ideal habitat and water temperature for spawning, but to come down to the lower lock, it's just not suitable. But they are slowly migrating through the system. Nature will dictate what survives and what lives, and if we put enough fish in there that there's a sustainable population, over the next 5-10 years, them fish will reproduce and things will balance out.